It's time to face it. There are just too many to-do applications out there, right? There's Notion and Things and OmniFocus. Some people will tell you that TickTick is the best. Some people will say it's Todoist. And it'd just be impossible to try them all out, right? Wrong. Well, maybe. But it didn't stop me from trying. What's going on, everyone? My name is Mitchell, and here at the Tech Learning Network, we teach tech. We help you learn to build digital products, create digital designs, and become more productive using technology. If you're new to the channel, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button so you never miss an episode. In this video, I'm going to be talking all about to-do list applications, and I'm going to be giving you my top three best to-do list applications for Mac OS. But before we get started, I just want to make note of a few things, right? First, it's important to keep in mind that this list is only my opinion. Task tracking is an incredibly personal experience, and everyone's criteria for grading these type of systems is just radically different. Okay, so without further ado, in absolutely no particular order, here are my top three best to-do list applications for Mac OS. First up, we have Todoist. Todoist. So I'm gonna jump into Todoist. I'm gonna show you a little bit how it works and just give you a kind of feel for some of the features that you might get when using this specific application versus others. Now, ease of use is something that's particularly important to me. I wanna be able to just jump into an application and immediately start using it. I want it to be incredibly intuitive. And as you can see, that's exactly what Todoist is. As plain as can be, you have this nice big button here that just says add task, and you could just, you know, add anything, right? So I could just say get my car washed. I could give it a little description. Go to splash. I could give this a due date, just say I'm gonna get this done this weekend. I could flag it as, you know, number one priority, and I could just click add task. And now that just is a living, breathing task in my inbox. But what if I wanted to get more specific than that? Todoist gives you all your essentials. You can go ahead and break all of your tasks into projects. You can decide whether you want your project to be in list mode or board mode. Board mode is particularly great for anybody that's a visual or spatial thinker. You could give your project a name. Why don't we just call this personal? You could give it a color, blue, and you could just hit add. Now, I could take my general to-do, get my car washed. I can select project, and I could just move it to my personal project. But categorizing things into projects is not what landed Todoist on this list. By far, the most important and powerful feature on Todoist is using its natural language processing capabilities. Now, what do I mean by natural language processing abilities? Well, I mean that when I actually type something like I think it, it will understand and grab my natural language patterns and sort them out automatically. Let me show you. So let's just pretend that I was creating a personal task. Let's just say that my task was to call my friend Frankie. So I want to say call Frankie. But when we're thinking about calling our friends, we're not thinking about them just in general. We have specific times or places in mind that we want to be having these conversations. So I want to say call Frankie tomorrow. Now, my task automatically knows that I'd like to call him tomorrow and presets that due date. Now, when I add my task, you can see that I have until tomorrow to complete it. But Todoist doesn't just understand dates. It also understands time. So if I were to create a new project, let's say work, I want to give this a nice orange color. And I want to add it. I want to go in to create a new task. Now I want to say, call Sandra about the budget tomorrow at 3 p.m. at, and now I can even give it a location, work. Now when I add that task, I can see that I have a due date of 3 p.m. tomorrow, one day left to do it. I'm doing it at work, and Todoist has automatically sectioned out all of the irrelevant language patterns that I'm using and just gives me a simple task of call Sandra about the budget. Its language capabilities are just too impressive to ignore. So maybe check out Todoist. Next up, we have Things. Now, I'm a bit biased here. I've been a Things user for many, many years, and I just can't recommend this app to people enough. Its elegant design makes it easy and just fun to use, and it's really not short on features either. Now, Things works a lot like Todoist, but I think it does it better. You have the ability to organize all of your tasks into areas and projects. Now, what's the difference between an area or a project? Well, an area refers to an overall grouping, so a specific space, and a project refers to a very specific goal. Now, let me give you an example. So let's pretend that you're a student. You want to create an area for school. You'd want to create a project for a certain class that you're in. And then you'd want to create headers for each assignment that you have. And you'd want to create general to-dos within those headers. Then you can quickly and easily, at a glance, go into your area, go into your projects, and decide when certain things are complete. And once you've completed an entire project, you get this nice little rewarding complete blue circle, which I just love. I love seeing all my tasks logged. But how do we go about actually assigning something a due date? Well, let's first start by adding a new task. Read new assigned book. And we have a couple of options here. We have our intended date and we have our deadline. Now, what's the difference between intended date and deadline? Intended date is the date that I intend to do something but may not get to it. And a deadline is when it has to be done. So we're gonna give this an intended date of tomorrow with a deadline of the 15th. And we're gonna flag this important. Now, when I click on this task, you'll see that I am intending to do it on Thursday, that it's flagged important. And here over in the corner, I can see that I have 14 days left to complete this task. Now, don't get me wrong. A lot of applications do what Things does, but I don't think they do it as well. I think for its elegance and its power, this is well worth your time. And finally, we have Any.do. Now, if you're watching this video because in the past you've just let all your task tracking systems slip to the wayside, then Any.do may be the app for you. Let me show you how it works. So when you go into Any.do, you'll see a fairly familiar task tracking app. You can go about creating a new task here in the top left. And you just give it your basic I want. So I want to write my to-do list video script. And I can add a note for ProductivityLab. And the best thing about Any.do is just that it's absolutely in your face. So as I'm creating this task, it's forcing me to create an intended time that I'm going to do this task, which sometimes other task trackers don't do. So you can see here that it's gonna ask me to remind me later today, this evening, tomorrow, next week, custom or someday, meaning I'm gonna get to it eventually, but not anytime soon. And once I just click this and click add task, it's happening. It's gonna remind me later today, 2 p.m. I could turn on and off this reminder. I can shift which list it's actually gonna be in. And I can mark this as done as soon as I've completed it. Now, one of the other things that I love about Any.do is that I'm actually able to add files or PDFs to my to-do list, right? So if I was gonna go about creating a task, which is review scripts for the week, and I'm doing this tomorrow, I can add this task, go into the task, and I can actually go about adding all of my different files and scripts right from that task window. Now, when I go about doing that task, all of my scripts are already there and I know exactly what I'm supposed to be looking at. And that is what landed Any.do on this list. Any.do is free on the App Store and it's a great choice for anybody that needs something that's in their face. And there you have it, my top three best to-do applications for Mac OS. Again, if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And again, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you never miss a video again. For now, I'm Mitchell. This is the Tech Learning Network. Thanks for watching.